Nina and Terrence, you are really the organizers and producers of this amazing Excellence in Education Awards that's happening here on WBBZ-TV. And Terrence, this was really your vision from your organization. Explain to our viewers what it's all about.
Well, the vision came to me, I believe, through my Lord and Savior, and I followed through with it. I believe that from my teaching time in the city of Buffalo, I believe that it's an opportunity to finally recognize our teachers, you know, who I've seen work throughout the years inside the schools, and they retire and they're receiving type of recognition. So I wanted to try to put a program together that we can recognize these teachers, these support staff and administrators that spend a lifetime with our children and never getting recognition.
Nina, this was going to be an event that was held at Roswell Park as something that people could go and see and the awards presented sort of in a traditional awards show fashion, but that couldn't happen because of all of the issues with the COVID pandemic.
Absolutely. So due to COVID, of course, we had to pivot really quickly. And thank goodness for our team and thank goodness to John, WBBZ, helped us to be able to really pivot and reimagine the program. And with that, we were able to come up with this telecast, an exclusive telecast on WBBZ-TV.
And it's going to be on Facebook Live. And the page that it's on is Excellence in Education. Tell us the Facebook page, Terrence, that you've organized.
Yes, it's Excellence in Education Awards, but the Facebook page is friendsforabetterbuffalo.org. So just go to friendsforabetterbuffalo.org and you can see things about the program, the struggles that we've been through, and the other things that we do with our community and across the United States.
One quick thing. So he said Excellence in Education Awards Buffalo, because we wanted to make sure we stood out and represented Western New York. So Excellence Education Awards Buffalo on Facebook.
And the Friends for a Better Buffalo have done lots of things, not just for the education community, but you know, you've been there through even with the Flint, Michigan water crisis. So this is an organization that's truly active in Western New York community and the world.
Absolutely. So Flint, Michigan is very near and dear to me. I'm actually from Michigan. I'm actually from that area. And so for Friends for a Better Buffalo to chime in and say, how can we help? It really did my heart very good. So that was one piece. And then we partnered with some other folks here in Buffalo and we helped out across the seas. So maybe Terrence can tell you a little bit about that.
Yes, like with Hurricane Dorian came and hit the islands. We was a group that responded. We had a fundraiser, a drive, you know, food drive, clothing drive. Constructed over 500 new houses and gave water purification units, over 1,500 water purification units. So some of the things that we like to do with Friends for a Better Buffalo, you know, not only help our community but help others, but we can teach others how to, you know, to use their hearts and give.
You are a Western New York icon because you've been at the General Motors plant, Nina, for many, many years.
Yes, over 25 years I've been working with General Motors in community relations, so this is near and dear to me. Western New York is where I call home now. I'm married to a Buffalonian, and so I've turned into this Buffalo Bills fan, so it's just an awesome thing. And so since I'm here, I might as well help the community, absolutely.
And, you know, the GM community and all of the Western New York community stepped up. You've really organized a group of A-listers, community icons, to come in and submit video messages and then come here to the station to make their presentation. So you've really gotten the community involved in addition to the education community, but all of our leaders and cultural icons.
Absolutely. Terrence and I both believe in relationships, and relationships are important to us. And because of those relationships, we were able to connect with some of those who believed in our vision and able to get them on board. And so I don't know if you want to say anything else about that, but it's truly about relationships.
Yes, and I'm grateful for this new relationship that we built with WBBZ, because in 1 month's time, you know, we went from a forum, from a stage setting, to television, and helped guide us through the whole situation and every step that went along with it. So in 1 month's time, we put a television program together. And it's been very stressful. It's been a lot of work in our committee, who had to just revamp everything that they're doing, retool their way of thinking, and see how we can get our commitments to recommit, you know, to be part of the program. And with the people that we have with the program, it's amazing. From the mayor of Buffalo, the former mayor of Buffalo, we have my former boss, and executive Bill Polian from the Buffalo Bills. And
Tim then Kennedy, presidents from colleges. I mean, we just have community leaders such as We Are Buffalo Strong. So we just have a gamut of folks from Western New York that's supporting this program.
And Sheila Brown with the after party over at Power 96.5 FM. And we have an after party there and Facebook Live. So it's been so much work that we put together to get this done. And first of all, and we most congratulate our our teachers that's in the city of Buffalo. Yeah. Those are the ones who put, who's carrying the load. They are in the trenches, and they are working with our kids, and they're the ones who make this all this happen.
Particularly now with the COVID.
Absolutely. So they had, as Terrence said, during these unprecedented times, they had to learn how to teach virtually. And we were talking to the teachers who were nominated and then became finalists. They were saying how much they missed their students. So being able to really acknowledge them and their hard work and what they put into our inspire our young people, we had to do it. We couldn't let this fall through the cracks. And thank goodness for our committee. We have a committee of about 25 people across Western New York, different communities, different backgrounds, and they came together and made this happen.
Different organizations.
Very
prime organizations here in the city of Buffalo. Yeah. And they took their time. We met as committee members on Saturdays and all throughout the week. I had about 1 million text messages and emails.
1 million and 1 for me, Terrence. Right. Yeah. Now, and you're a school board member at large as well, and I know this is going to be a challenging summer because we just don't know what's going to happen in the fall.
We have a great school board in the city of Buffalo. We have a team that's working together. We have a superintendent who's listening to us and trying to, you know, graph, you know, what we're trying to imply with equality. We try to include diversity, and we also working together to make sure each child is represented, that each child voice is heard. And, you know, that's the overall goal, you know, is our children and making sure that we can build a better communities and just make sure they have the best opportunity to succeed in life.
Now, you mentioned Bill Polian, and you mentioned the Buffalo Bills fan that you've become, Nita, because yes. Terrence, you were on the team in the training camp for a while. Tell us about your connection to the Bills.
Practice squad. I came in, I was called in, and it was a great opportunity for me in my life. And, you know, the alumni, and we meet every year, and we just try to make sure that we can keep this going. You know, let's go Buffalo.
Let's go Buffalo.
And Bills Mafia, stand up. Bills Mafia, stand up.
They do. When are we going to see this, Nita, on WBBZ TV?
Check us out on WBBZ Sunday, June 14th at 8 p.m. I want to see everyone, Buffalonians, show up. Tune in Sunday, June 14th, 8 p.m.
And you can donate while you're watching for the scholarship fund. There's a little QR code that we'll have on the screen. And the website is friendsforabetterbuffalo.org.
That's correct. Friendsforabetterbuffalo.org. Please go to our website and look at opportunities. Also, you can help volunteer and join the organization.
And one other thing, I forgot. If you're not able to watch it on television, of course, Facebook. Facebook on your phones.
Yeah, Facebook Live on that page we talked about. And we'll be across the world. And we'll have it up on YouTube as well, so if people miss it on TV. But they got to watch on the June 14th at 8 p.m. right here.
June 14th, 8 p.m.
Thank you, WBBZ TV, for supporting and helping out.
And I want to thank everybody out there for watching The Big Picture. I want to thank you for watching WBBZ TV. As always, this is your TV station, your local TV station, and we will see you next time on The Big Picture.